Good morning, Rules Committee. My name is Shane Harris, the president and founder of the People's Association of Justice Advocates. I'm proud to stand before you today as the people's champ. I'm here to oppose this item, which is coming before the council's rules committee today. While today's request of this committee to advance a sales tax increase ballot measure to the full council may well be well intended due to city services that are lacking, and it carries unintended consequences that sit on the undertone of this ask. Number one, there are already various other tax hike measures potentially headed to the November ballot, and one is already on the ballot to raise the county's sales tax. This happening, of course, in a year where inflation is at a record high numbers, and it is hitting the pockets of our residents. Inflation is hitting businesses and supply and demand, but it is hitting the everyday common family in the grocery stores, at the pharmacy, and of course, in the cost of rent. Because let's just be honest, the rent is too damn high. The city's long-standing mismanagement of taxpayer dollars, including under this administration, is the overwhelming cloud over this ask. We're talking about wise and efficient spending, right? The question is where? Whether you are talking about the purchasing of 101 Ash Street, which was never analyzed, but rather leased under Mayor Faulkner and purchased under Mayor Gloria's leadership, as he doubled down on buying this building, even against the advice of his own city attorney, allocating money, the taxpayers' money, from stormwater infrastructure to buy this building. Or whether you're talking about the disinvestment of promises made and never kept to neighborhoods south and eastern parts of our city that don't have good park infrastructure, street lights, and other basic necessities. Three, finally, when I was preparing to run for San Diego City Council District 4 in a vacant special election, I went before the Municipal Employees Association, who I happen to have great respect for. I value our city employees, every single one of them. One of the main questions I was asked, though, of all candidates was running, was whether they would be willing to support a proposed sales tax increase, and I told them no. I was the only person opposed to this because of the times we are living in and the unintended consequences of having multiple tax increases on the November ballot, as if we are not already living in America's finest city, not a city such as Anaheim, which was mentioned in the presentation. The fact is that this city is the most expensive, not the most affordable. In my conversations with MBA, the focus was mainly on city staffing, not parks, infrastructure, and assets. The focus was filling vacancies and increasing pay. Now, they want to ask for more money from taxpayers, a part of a bad habit in this city's history of borrowing, promising, mismanaging, and borrowing again. If this measure goes to the ballot, it will fail.
Thank you very much. Thank you. That does conclude your time.